Hey guys, Tech Timmy here. So in this video, I'm going to be doing a review of the Dell Inspiron 16 Plus laptop. I will cover technical specifications, connectivity, performance and battery life, and I will also review some of the pros and cons. So without further ado, let's get into the review.
Oh boy, it's Tech Timmy time.
Okay, so I thought I would start with just a general overview of this laptop right here. Overall, I'll just start by saying I'm happy with it. It is not perfect. There are definitely some issues that I will get into a little bit later. But in general, so this is a business laptop, solid business laptop for professional students and creators. I would say in terms of a productivity laptop, it works great so that your Microsoft Office applications, your email, web browsing, and all that good stuff, it is, the performance has been absolutely outstanding. So the, I guess the chef's kiss, I really don't like that term, but I just said it, I guess, is the large monitor. So it's 16, it's a 16 by 10 display, and it's got plenty of vertical space going up and down. So that 16 by 10 is great for allowing you to read long documents. It is slightly larger than the overall standard laptop, but about as heavy. For smaller laptop bags, like I had this really nice sling bag that my older laptop would fit into, this will not fit in there. So you do need to sort of take the overall dimensions and size into account. It boots up super fast. There's a slight lag during heavy video editing and also hardcore gaming. So this is not a high-end laptop if you are a heavy gamer and or you do a ton of video editing. This is you're gonna get frustrated over time. I have had no issues whatsoever with using this to edit my shorts using CapCut, for instance, been totally fine. But I did notice some lag once I switched over to longer videos. I generally use this with an external keyboard and mouse. I'm probably not the best person to talk about the keyboard and mouse here, although I have used it and I can comment and I will in a few minutes. But overall, I would just say it's a beautiful laptop with an attractive design, and it's got sort of this unique ice blue color finish here that is not really a thing. I'll get into that in a second. I think what we'll do is keep this interesting. I will switch over to the laptop and I'll flash some stuff, some of the specs up on screen through the power of editing. Just kind of keep this moving and keep it a little bit more interesting because you guys don't look at me throughout the whole video, I'm sure. So let's do that now. So I will switch over to the laptop. We'll cover the specs and then we'll get into some of the, a little bit of the nitty gritty in terms of the performance stuff. So let's do it. Design and build quality. Featuring a premium 16-inch 2.5K display with a 16 by 10 aspect ratio, the Dell Inspiron 16 Plus 7640 is a solid business laptop delivering vibrant, detailed visuals. You can choose between a 120Hz mode for super smooth motion or a 60Hz setting to conserve battery life. The robust yet refined chassis with slim bezels and a backlit keyboard maximizes the viewing area and provides comfortable use even in low light. The integrated fingerprint reader adds security, though the port layout isn't as efficient as I would like it to be when connecting multiple peripherals. While I was initially put off by the ice blue design, it's really not a thing, and it turns out that the laptop has only slight blue undertones and appears mostly polished silver and chrome. Overall, the design successfully blends modern aesthetics with durability and functionality for both creative and business tasks. For now, let's jump on over to the computer while I run down the detailed specifications. All right, guys, so at the risk of being a little cheesy or whatever, I thought I would just flash some of the specs of the model of the laptop that I own up on the laptop screen just to kind of make things a little bit more interesting here. This is the 7640 model. So this has the Intel Core i7 processor. So it's the Core i7 family. 13620H model of that particular chip. So this is basically their one down from the top of the line right now. So the i9 would have been would have been better performance overall over the i7. I went with the i7 because it makes it more affordable, and again, for productivity, i7 should do you just fine. So I started to say, so this laptop has 16 gigabytes of RAM, not upgradable to 32 gigabytes, which I think would have done me a little bit better in terms of just being able to multitask. So just to kind of finish up in terms of the specs, it has a 1 terabyte NVMe SSD speed hard disk, which I've had no issues with whatsoever. So the 1 terabyte, a little bit lower than I think I would prefer to have gotten a 2 terabyte hard drive on this guy, but with external storage being a thing, not an issue for me at all. I keep most of my data on my external storage drive that I have hooked up both to this and also my main PC. Whoa. So it's Intel Arc graphics for media. The resolution on this guy has been stellar. I can get super high resolution and I can fit a lot of stuff on the small laptop screen. I typically am plugging this into, when I'm home, into my smart TV, which it gives me a giant screen. And as I said before, I also hook into a Logitech mouse and a Logitech keyboard that I love. I will flash that up on screen as well at some point during this video as B-roll to show you what my typical setup with this guy looks like, just so you know. And then, so the Wi-Fi seems excellent. I get solid Wi-Fi here with my 1 gigabit Ethernet connection. This guy is typically right on top of my router and I get around 800 megabits per second. And Verizon basically confirmed that. That's par for the course if you have a 1 gig connection. So and then in terms of the ports, I'll actually get into in the next little segment here. All right, so in terms of ports, this is where I feel this laptop is a little bit lacking, both in the number of USB Type-C ports particularly, and then also the fact that everything is positioned very closely together, which can make getting dongles and things in here a little bit of a pain. But so here we have our audio out, an HDMI port, which is where I hook in my external monitor. In my case, I use my flat screen TV, a USB Type-A, of course, and then USB Type-C. So this is the charging brick that comes with it. And the charging brick is, interestingly, you guessed it, USB Type-C. So when you put that in there, now you have how many USB Type-C ports, do you think? 0. So that can be a little bit of a pain. I bought an external device that I hook into here that I can basically do pass through in terms of charging, and then also it gives me multiple HDMI ports at the same time. I'll include a link to a video that I did on that guy as well. I'll flash something up on screen and so forth. And then in terms of the other side, so let's remove this guy for now because we're doing fine on battery power, which I'll also tell you guys about. But so on the other side, we have an additional USB type A port here, and I have this connected into, and I could go Bluetooth on this to free up that port, I will say. But I do like having the less latency with my Logitech MX Master Mini Mouse and keyboard by using their, by using their dongle there. And I believe that other one is for a display port. But so that is essentially it in terms of ports. I think the biggest miss here is actually, as I said, is in the USB Type-C. So we'll go back to the screen and I will give you some additional thoughts and specifications. We'll flash those up on screen and then we'll wrap things up. All right, so here we are back in presentation mode, if you will. I'll just touch on performance and battery life super quick. The multitasking works actually very well with the i7 processor. I do think having the 16 gigabytes of RAM is somewhat limiting if you have many applications, as I tend to do, open at once. I would say go with the 32 gigabyte model if that is a concern for you. The graphics are excellent from the Intel Arc graphics software. Looks great for my creative. The videos display great on screen. When I'm editing designs and so forth, it looks amazing. And then it's consistent daily performance for work and some play. The battery life kind of sadly doesn't last as long as my former business laptop, and it could just be because that laptop actually was not as nice, had much lower specifications, and maybe that's why it just lasted longer. I was getting maybe 12 to 14 hours on a single charge with my Dell business laptop. Can't even remember what the model was on that. This one gets about 8 to 10 hours if it's idle, and then if I'm doing heavy editing, heavy work, and so forth, I'm noticing it starts to cap off. I start to get a warning after around 6 to 7 hours. I'm typically plugged in, so not an issue, but if you travel a lot, you have long flights and so forth, that might be a concern. You're gonna wanna make sure that you're charged. The other thing that I noticed is that on the fingerprint reader, it worked great for the first couple of tries, and then it just was forcing me to enter my PIN after that. If you guys have any experience with that, drop a comment down below, and I appreciate it. I have not troubleshooted that yet at all. I've just been entering my PIN in a lazy fashion. I will look into that, and if you guys are interested in knowing more about whether or not I was able to resolve the fingerprint issue reader, drop a comment below. I will say a little bit elusive, I didn't realize this, the fingerprint button is the power button. When you run your finger along it gently, that will read your fingerprint when it works. Okay, so now I'll cover just the general pros and cons of this laptop. The main pro is you have an exceptional large display with crisp graphics. It's got fast boot times. The 1 gigabyte storage is gonna be ample storage, I think, for most people, unless you do a lot of heavy video editing. And the connectivity, the Wi-Fi connection has been great. I don't like, in terms of cons, I don't like the fact that you only have that one USB-C port, and that is going to be occupied by USB-C charging, unless you buy an external device that will give you more ports. I have noticed some lag during long video editing. The battery performance, I'm gonna call that average under heavy load. And there's limited upgrade options, so I'm not 1,000% sure on this, but I suspect that I cannot upgrade the RAM on this guy. Again, if you guys know, or if I get anything wrong in this video, drop a comment down below, and I would appreciate it. And then the other thing I'll say is that Windows installation, this is a Windows thing, probably not a Dell laptop thing, but it took almost 3 hours of rebooting and retooling and having to be present in front of the screen in order to get Windows installed. I would say in 2025, not acceptable, but that is a pet peeve of mine, I guess, in terms of Windows. But again, overall, I'll jump back to where I started here, and I'll give you my sort of verdict on the laptop. Okay, so just to wrap up my review of the Dell Inspiron 16 Plus laptop, strong design, a high quality display, and competitive specifications make this a solid laptop for productivity work and then also some creative tasks. As I said earlier in the video, if you do a lot of gaming and or high-end creative work or intensive creative work, then you're probably gonna be a little disappointed with this laptop. Go with the i9 processor, 32 megabytes of RAM, and so forth. You need to make sure that your laptop basically matches the specifications for the work that you do. This has been great for me as a business laptop and a second laptop in addition to my main high-end gaming PC that I use for my heavy editing work and then also when I'm gaming and so forth. I will also say that I'm no way affiliated with Dell, and this is not a paid review. All opinions are my own. I will drop a link to this down below in the description. It will be an affiliate link. If you use it, all proceeds go to support the channel. If you got any value from this, please give a thumbs up and consider subscribing for a fun take on tech. And I hope to see you in the next video.